But here's the thing, because I'm not traditionally good with women, you know? Like, I'm not good with women. Because you hear people, they're like, hey, this guy's good with women, you know? And when I didn't know what that meant, I'm like, oh, why is that? And they go, oh, because he sees different women all the time. And I'm like, ah, that makes as much sense as going, hey, this guy, he's really good at jobs. Why is that? Oh, he has to get a new one every couple days. You know? That doesn't mean he's good at jobs. That means he's good at the interview process. And as soon as he gets in the office, everyone's like, where the fuck all the Pence and Hope go? Remember we had Pence and Hope? And where's Greg? Ah, the building's on fire. You know? Because women are great, you know? But no one, if anyone's like, I love this group, that they have issues. You know, there's assholes everywhere, you know? But there's beautiful people too. It's too wordy. This thing, right? Because I think that you just should be honest with people. Because some people trick people into things. Oh, you don't need to fucking trick people. Just fucking tell them what you want. Why are you tricking people into things? That's crazy, you know? Like, I can't sleep with a lady unless I actually give a shit about her, you know? Because, like, I know people who can, and good for you. That's not for me. Because every time I've tried sleeping with someone I didn't give a shit about, I felt like I was masturbating with their soul. You know, like I turn their body into a giant hand and I'm just like, fuck, that hand has feelings and wants breakfast. This is weird. You know, but some people could do that and whatever, as long as you're not tricking people into it, you know? Because, like, you call people on that shit, though, and they're like, and they're like, don't hate the player, hate the game. And I'm like, first of all, don't tell me what to fucking hate. I'm an adult. I'll hate whatever the hell I want. I'll hate the player, the game, the general managers, the owners. I'll hate the mascot. I don't give a fuck. You know, and secondly, how can you consider yourself a player in a game if the person you're playing against doesn't even know they're involved? Like, how many times have you been playing a game and you're like, what the fuck, I'm playing a game? And I lost? And where'd this baby come from? This weird game. All I'm saying is if you really want to be a player, walk up to the lady and be like, hey, I want to fuck you, I want to leave you, I never want to talk to you again, and I want to tell all my friends about it. Want to play? There's the rules. What do you think? Right? Because they can be like, I'll fucking play. I'll show you who's getting played, you fucking idiot. You ever heard of 50%? No, sorry. That means she's going to marry him and then leave him. Then who got played? But I think every time you get married, like say you get divorced once, if you get married again, you only walk away with 25%. The person you marry gets 75%. You know? Do you get what I mean? Because you're bad at marriage, you get less. The second time, and the third time, you get 12.5. I'm just hitting this guy. He's divorced, and he's in debt. Who wants a date? He'll marry you after. He owns a house still. You get half a house. It's true, he says. Line up outside. I'll point him out with the flashlight on my phone. I'll just be following him around. This guy's lonely enough to lose half his shit. To anyone that's fucking got the goal to hang out with them. Right. But as I was saying, but that's the thing, right? With this only player hit the game bullshit, sometimes I meet people and within the first like 30 seconds, they'll be like, I slept with like 150 chicks. And I'll always be like, that's great. You slept with like 150 chicks, but how many of them fucking enjoyed it? You know, how much joy did you bring in this world versus regret and shame with your filthy cock, you bag of trash? What are those numbers, slugger? No one gives a shit about your at-bats. How many times did you ding that ball out of the park and it walked back willingly? Fought through the crowd. Where is he? Where is he? You know? I don't know. This is just stupid. Right? Because that's the thing. It's nuts. The world's nuts. I don't understand it. Like, when the Me Too movement started happening, I was like, what? There's that many fucking weirdos out there? This is crazy. And I was glad they were getting called out. And I think the next step in the process is to train all women to be ninjas. I don't think there's another route. Right? I think you all gotta be ninjas. That's it. That way, if a dude ever tries to grab your tit willy-nilly, you could grab his hand, shove it up his ass, wear him like a purse until he learns his lesson. Right? Or fuck it. Grab both his hands, shove them both up his ass, you got yourself a backpack. Because you shouldn't be grabbing tits willy-nilly. No. They're fucking magical. Mainly because they're attached to women. Like, I don't think I'd be as gung-ho about titties if they were attached to trees. You know, in the middle of winter, I'm like, we gotta go camping right now! Right now, I don't give a shit, I'm calling it! I don't need a tent! I don't need a tent! You know? Because you shouldn't grab a tit willy-nilly. You should be cordially invited. It should be a handwritten letter. Save the date. Bird flies there, gives it to you. It can be a falcon too, depending on her. You know? Fucking thing comes swooping in, what the fuck? If you dodge too many times, the bird goes, you could have had something if you just had some fucking cojones, bro. You know? No, because you should be cordially invited. And there should be fanfare, red carpet, there's press there, you know? They're like, hey, come here. That's all, what are you going to do in there? It's like, I don't know. I was just gonna hang out and see what happens. Well, whatever happens, happens. Okay, cool. I don't know. But whatever. You got it. Cordially fighting. Right? Because that's the thing. Because titties are magical. Right? Because when you get touch one, it centers your chi, makes you feel like one with the universe, and it absorbs all your doubt, shame, and fear. But that's when you're invited to. If you're not, a whole other ton of shit happens. Right? But that's also why I think titties get saggy, because they get touched by too many shameful men who absorb all that shame, and then they begin to droop. Which is also why you should respect a saggy titty, because it saved a lot of lives. That's right. That's what I'm saying. Perky tits are the work of the devil. Selfish as fuck, those perky tits. But you guys have been a lot of fun. That's it for me. Thank you so much for coming. I appreciate it.
Pat Burtscher, everybody. Give it all for Pat. Yeah.